Empaths are highly sensitive to energy around them, and energy that is interacting with them or engaging from a distance. And yes, that distance can be absolutely within the universe, not just on our planet, and certainly not just in the immediate community or even the state or country. Empaths vibrate on a frequency that really does belong to themselves. And here's what I mean. Empaths, because we feel energy so highly intensely, we tend to create this bubble of frequency. And why do we do that? We do it out of a defense mechanism. Most empaths don't even realize they're doing it, but it's a natural form of protection. See, we're the soul within our human, and our human's job is really to protect us, the soul within her or him. But our human goes against what we are all about, which is infinite, abundant energy. We are timeless, and we don't have a mortality rate or lifespan. Our human, however, lives in a third dimension and absolutely has a mortality rate, a mortality lifespan. Our human's very aware that she or he is only gifted life for a short time in the physical plane on Earth. We, however, understand a very different awareness. And when people wake up to that awareness, it's called spiritual awakening. Meaning, you come into a wave of enlightenment that says, aha, I know now for a fact that what I've been experiencing that can't be explained by human logic is actually happening. Along with that awareness or enlightenment comes an even heightened, more heightened, sensitive awareness of energy, meaning you begin to feel energy on a heightened level over your human. You begin to dream more frequently and absolutely more vibrantly. And you begin to pick up on messages very clearly. The thing is, those messages are coming in from other people's energy and objects. Some of that energy, the messages that you're picking up on, are frequencies from within different dimensions. That's right. Empaths are that powerful. So the next time you're picking up on messages that are totally against or have nothing to do with what you were just thinking about or what you're doing, and you really question, why did I just think of that? It could be a very negative energy that comes in, and it could be a very godly, divine energy that comes in. But you pick up on it nonetheless. So, how do we turn it off? Can we turn it off? Well, yes, we absolutely can turn off that energy from driving us crazy. Empaths are that powerful that empaths can say no to energy interacting with them. Empaths that are unevolved or unaware of the power in which they really do have the ability to harness just get so absorbed, are afraid to go into big places, end up saying they don't like people, and just try to stay away from the crowds, try to just be a homebody, and really do break more plans than they're able to make. Because it's just because they're so overrun and just drained by the energy within the frequencies that are around them and trying to engage them at all times. So if you can imagine energy being paintballs, you know, you have a little toy gun, paintballs, and energy are the balls of paint that the gun shoots out. Well, an empath is getting hit by these paintballs 24/7, nonstop, until they learn how to harness the energy that they were gifted to turn those paintballs off and to literally control the paintball gun that's being operated from another source of energy. And so that energy stops coming towards them and affecting them. How do we do that? Well, one of the ways that I have learned how to turn that energy off is to absolutely remember I am the soul within my human. Understanding that, I understand that there are two forms of responsibility here. My human controls the physical plane, governs the life that I am blessed to live in on earth. I, as the soul within my human, govern the infinite, unlimited, untapped potential connected to a divine source in the rest of the universe. All light, beautifully divine energy. My human is dense matter, still energy, but very grounded, very limited, and very much in need of uplifting and celebration and anything that picks up her ego, which is her, the shadow. Knowing that, I know my human has to have a job to do. So the best way that I have found to control the energy from interacting with me so that I can live my day, I can go into stores and be okay, I can go to events and I can engage people, and I do a lot of speaking engagements and interaction with my clients and with as keynote speaker and things of that nature, do a lot of talks. I know how to have my personal bubble of this energy field that keeps me protected and stops me from absorbing others' energy or other energy or other people's energy or other objects' energy. So the best way that I have learned to do that is to let my human do her job. Remember, your human's job is to protect you. The second we begin to go spiritual woo-woo, if you will, and we're just meditating, we're just burning incense, we're burning sage, we are burning sweet grass, we're using essential oils, we're yoga, we're all these things, meditative or praying, and we're doing all these things spiritual, and we forget that we have this earthly life to live, and it is all humanly logical. It is all reasoning. It is all justifiable. It is all very height, width, length, very specific, very measured, very timed existence. Then we are absolutely really leaving a humongous path wide open for energy to come on in and attack us. So remember, you have to let your human do your human's job, which is to protect you. And once you start doing that, you will see that you won't be so exhausted. You won't hesitate going into stores anymore. You won't be saying that you don't like people. You will absolutely love being around people because you will get to pick and choose what energy you allow in and energy you don't allow in. And even when you're around yourself, because in your own personal space, you're still picking up on energy. Empaths are that sensitive, where they are picking up on energy, even if they are at a library reading a book, they all of a sudden can start crying because someone else's energy interacted with theirs, kind of like in the crosshairs, and or energy from way over somewhere else in the universe, they're picking up on, and they can either get extremely angry, extremely sad, depressed. The possibilities are endless because it's all energy. And an empath is just that attuned with the different frequencies going on, and there are an unlimited amount. Not one human being knows how many frequencies are going on. And if you can imagine, all the people on Earth have all kinds of frequencies going on. So that's just one group of energy sources. So an empath picks up on these energy frequencies and wavelengths, and it can be very overwhelming. To the point of some empaths cannot, they don't feel like they can work. And that's completely understandable until they are able to learn how to let their human do their human's job, which is to protect them, the soul within their human.